Hey, it's Insane Gamers, and welcome back to another Pokemon X and Y Wi-Fi battle. Today, I'm battling Robotnik, who is a subscriber, and you can find his channel link in the description. So, this battle was sort of interesting, very close, very exciting. I've got some awesome new Pokemon to try out. This is a UU battle, by the way, in case you couldn't tell, but of course you could tell, because, man, there are some scary Pokemon in UU. I have to say, Alakazam, Infernape, even Goodra. I didn't even think Goodra would ever be UU, but I guess it does make sense, you know? It is a pseudo-legendary, but it's more defensive. Anyway, that's besides the point. He's got a sick, nasty shirt on where he, like, splattered paint all over himself. That's pretty cool. And I got the freaking panda hat. Amazing. So anyway, I lead with Top Star. He leads with Goodra, predicting my Top Star lead. What a beast! He gets the gooey on me, and now my speed falls. But here's the thing. I'm slower than him now. And let's be honest, Goodra's special attack, probably not the highest special attack stat in the game. So I know that I can take a Dragon Pulse if he decides to go for Dragon Pulse, and he does. And just as I thought, I take it quite nicely, and I'm able to take it out with a close combat, which is amazing. The fact that I was slower allowed me to live that because I didn't get the defense drop, and Goodra's defense not that great. This hip on top is Adamant Max Attack Life Orb, so my gosh, that's a powerful close combat right there. Anyway, awesome. I got his Goodra out of the way on the second turn of the battle, which is nice. So he sends in Rhyperior now, and I'm like, right, you're sending a Rhyperior into me. This seems like a little bit of a bait. I'm thinking I should get out of here. He probably wants me to close combat him, so I'll die, because I need to keep this thing alive. It's got priority, and his team is looking pretty weak to priority. So I send in George to get the Sandstorm up and just to tank anything this wants to do. Yeah, it really didn't do anything, and I can assume that that guy's adamant, since these are, you know, Rhyperiors are normally adamant, because they do a lot of damage, they got a lot of attack. Anyway, he's got the Ice Punch. I'm like, what? That's a little bit crazy. Okay, then. I just went for the Earthquake, expecting them to set up rocks or whatever, but wow. He's got the Weakness Policy Rhyperior, ladies and gentlemen, and I fell right into this trap, hook, line, and sinker. I even set up the Sandstorm for him. My gosh, I am absolutely screwed. I've got to switch out of here. I really want to keep George alive. I'm going to go into my Alakazam, who's packing the Focus Sash, and I'm not going to take Sandstorm damage because of the Magic Guard ability. So he's going to Earthquake me, obviously going to bring me down to my Sash, and I'm going to live at one. So now I just got to hope that he doesn't switch, and he doesn't switch, which is amazing. I get the Energy Ball off, and luckily, even through the Sand and the Solid Rock, manages to kill it. That was freaking intense. I almost got swept by Rhyperior right off the bat. Very nice. Anyway, I go for the Fighting Spirit bullet here. Apparently my Fighting Spirit isn't, I don't know, big enough, so I just miss. I don't even know why I bother running Focus Blast. Is there even any point? It just misses anyway. Whatever. So Empoleon didn't take damage. Big deal. It wouldn't have even done half. Empoleon's a beast. So I send in George again. This was stupid, okay? I should have gone into Hitmontop. I don't know why I went into George. I was thinking in my head that I want to pull off my strategy. And here's the strategy of this team, and it revolves completely around Gigalith. Shiny Gigalith named Taric, because, you know, gems are outrageous. And this guy's running Assault Vest in the Sandstorm with Sand Force, and it's so amazingly tanky, but unfortunately he gets a critical hit burn, and my world just fell to pieces right there. I was so devastated by that. That absolutely sucks, because this thing is an absolute monster in the sand. I mean, it really is. With that Sand Force ability, it can take things out like crazy. So even though I'm burned, I still do about half. I guess that's not too bad, you know. Opal for Harmony, whatever else Taric says. What does Taric say? you're nothing more than glass, waiting to be smashed. Unfortunately, I'm the one getting smashed. So yeah, maybe next battle I'll get Taric to work. Who knows? Anyway, props to Weedle Tweedle. Mike for getting me that shiny Gigalith. Thank you very much. Anyhow, So I am a little bit of at a loss right now. I figure, well, this is what I should have done originally, so let's just do it now. Unfortunately for me, I've got Life Orb, and the sandstorm is raging, so my health bar is not looking very healthy right now. He's gonna switch into two scoops and just take a close combat, which of course is gonna get completely rolled by, because it's an Alakazam, and, you know, obviously I can just go for a priority move and kill it, which is exactly what I'm gonna do, because Alakazam is a scary Pokemon, and I don't really want it around. Now, luckily, I do have another priority user on this team with Entei, so I'm not too terribly worried if this guy goes down. He goes into his Monkey Butt. That's a nice name for an Infernape. I would never name Infernape Monkey Butt, obviously. In fact, I have one named Monkey Butt, I think. I don't know. Point is, did you see that Mach Punch damage? That did half. Hip on top, you beast. So I'm gonna switch into George here, expecting him to Mach Punch, but does he Mach Punch? No. Maybe he's just playing really well this game and predicted my switch, or maybe he doesn't even have Mach Punch. Well, he has to have Mach Punch. Why would he have Fire Punch if he doesn't have Mach Punch? Anyway, point is, I get rolled by that Fire Punch because it's boosted by Iron Fist. So unfortunately, George is gonna go down here too. So it's not looking good for me at the moment. My team's kinda got torn to shreds, and it's mostly because of stupid mistakes I have made. Yeah, I do that a lot, in case you haven't noticed. I just kind of derp around, I hit whatever button, you know. It's only Pokemon. I'm normally doing something else while I'm battling. Anyway, I send in Entei. I'm gonna get hurt by the rocks, I'm gonna get hurt by the sand. Entei's not enjoying this right now. But luckily, I got the E-Speed. So I'm just gonna go straight for that, hoping that maybe he'll go into someone that isn't Empoleon. And he goes into his Salad Days. I don't know why he sent this in. I'm guessing it was just Death Fodder, because there's really no reason ever to send this into an Entei. But, you know, it is what it is. I've got Adamant Nature, I've got Life Orb, and that thing is definitely not tanky at all, because it just got completely wrecked by E-Speed. That Pokemon is kind of annoying, because it can set up Quiver Dances, but at the same time, it's really, really kind of useless, because the only thing it can get is Grass-type attacks. It's Grass-type attacks and a Hidden Power, and if you can't get Hidden Power, good luck killing anything that resists grass, that's all I gotta say. So it goes into Day-to-Day again. Now, I did a quick damage calc, and I saw that Sacred Fire might kill it from this range, but might is not good enough for me. I don't do well with might. It has to be, it will kill. So I just Death Fodder Top Star, and now I've got to start playing like a beast if I want to win this, okay? I've got to pull out the sick plays. The Sandstorm dies down, which is good, just in time for me to send out my new Pokemon here, Vileplume. And Vileplume here is a physically defensive Vileplume with some attacks that I can't remember right now, but it doesn't matter, because here I decide to make the plays, ladies and gentlemen. I knew he was gonna switch into his fire type. I went for the Sludge Bomb on the Empoleon expecting the switch. I know. Sometimes I even astound myself at how good I am at this game. I mean, seriously. Anyway, so this Vileplume is pretty beastly in this battle, you're gonna see. He sends an Alakazam, okay? Goes for the Psy Shock, and I thought I was dead right here, but Vileplume, being the beast, decides to live the Psy Shock because of its max defense, bold max HP, and it just completely destroys the Alakazam. I'm just blown away at this point. I thought I was just gonna get rolled by a Psychic, but of course I would live a Psy Shock because I'm physically defensive, so here we go. It's Vileplume versus Day-Day. Now, I've got Giga Drain. I also have Moonlight. I don't actually wind up ever using Moonlight, I think, just because that would be kind of mean, and I don't really feel like being mean. Although, maybe I do feel like being mean. Who knows? I've got this and Entei left, so I've pretty much got this in the bag if I just get Empoleon down to a pretty low range of health. I know I can take it out with a Sacred Fire, considering I don't miss, because, you know, Sacred Fire does have 95 accuracy, and, well, you know, sometimes it misses. But anyway, he goes for the Scald, of course, gets the burn. I mean, why wouldn't you get the burn? I do have the Aromatherapy, but there's really no point in using it. I mean, I could moonlight on aromatherapy and just make this guy hate his life, but there's really no reason to do that other than my own amusement, and I know you guys don't really want to watch that. By the way, while we're stalling, let me tell you about a fight I got in with a customer today at the gas station. Now, this was a little bit silly, okay? I get the effects for, by the way, that's kind of nice. This guy told me the wrong pump and then came back inside wanting to know why his pump wasn't working. Of course, it was on the wrong pump, so I'm like, well, I can move it for you. And he, like, started flipping out at me. Like, I'm stealing his $20. He thought I was trying to steal his $20. He was flipping out at me. And then the customer standing, like, to the right of him was like, dude, seriously, he just said he's gonna move your gas over. He's not stealing your $20. Just leave. So thank you to that customer for being a good human being and defusing the situation, because that guy looked like he was about ready to jump across the counter and, like, strangle me for his frickin' $20, which he told me the wrong pump. So, yeah. And then I got a little bit sassy with him as he walked out the door, but, you know, sometimes you gotta do that. Anyway, I finally managed to kill Wildplume here. He finally managed to kill Wildplume. So I'm gonna send in Entei. He is paralyzed. He has no hope of victory. Mwahaha! So, I'm just gonna flame charge, because I know that won't miss, because knowing my luck, I will miss and lose. So, anyway, that was a pretty good battle. Very close battle. 17 hit points there. Anyway, good game. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. See you next time.